appreciate it.
You know that, pal?
Thanks.
Dina wants to talk to you.
What makes you say that, pal?
She just was telling me.
Dina wants to talk to me. She wants to talk to you. I'll take one of those burgers, and those burgers are ready. Are those burgers ready yet, pal?
I don't... I'll check.
Good. Hey, keep an eye on Dawn. She's after that clap boy again. Dina?
Chris?
So what's on your mind, sweetheart?
I told you, no more kissing. Is that appropriate? Do you know me?
Yeah, I hear you. You're yelling in my ear. Can I have my video right now?
We'll see. What are you going to do, Jenny?
Stop it!
Hey, your mom.
No, Jenny, not. I spend as much time as I can with that up at the home. I'd like to spend more.
That's understandable.
So what I want to do is, I want to sell it all off. Got myself a nice little one-bedroom up around here so I can be with him these last few months. I don't think he's got much more than that.
Really want me to say, I'm glad you came to me. Can you just come by the office on Monday? We'll start drawing up some papers. Okay? I can't give you the world for the place, but I'll give you a fair price.
I know you will, Chris.
It's a good thing about old friends. You don't have to worry about getting a loop job. How'd you do, bud?
You had a son, Dad.
Consistently?
The last one and once before that. I think
you're going to have to hang with them. Gotta get your free throws to win
ball games. I know. That guy's got a major thing for Pig. He's pretty much a douche. They went out like one time.
That's the leather. So you didn't go in once, huh?
Maureen makes my hair gross.
Wouldn't want that, now would we? fed the dogs yet?
Ryan will do it when he gets up. Dogs can wait.
Nice when it's quiet like this, isn't it? average?
7'10". Pretty consistent.
Good. That's good.
You can't see anything?
Does it look like I got anything?
You should turn down the handle.
Fine. You do that. You can come along with me, babe.
Me too?
Sure, sweetie. You too. Follow us, son. Watch your step. Okay. I want you guys to move all this junk from the south end to the other side of the cellar. And you sweep up the floor.
Before dinner?
Yes, before dinner, Peg.
Why?
Because your dad asked you to. You don't have a problem with that, do you, Brian?
No. Where do you want us to move all the stuff?
In the dump trailer. If it's small and burnable, put it in the burn barrel. You're going to need some gloves. There's a couple pair in the barn. Have you fed the dogs yet?
It's Peg's turn. I had morning.
Peg?
Fine, I'll feed the dogs. I'll go get the gloves.
Is there mice down here?
Could be.
Should I get some cheese?
Oh, I don't think that's a very good idea. Belle, you organize things around here. With three of you, shouldn't take very long. I've got some things to do at the house.
Chris? Why are we doing this?
You'll see. Trust me on this one.
What's he doing? Peg, you scared the hell out of me.
Sorry. I couldn't sleep.
Well, try. School in the morning.
What's Dad doing?
Go to bed, Peggy. It's late.
Good night, Mom.
Good night, honey. Thank you.
both sides.
That's right. But we forgot to raise our hand again, didn't we, Jackie?
Sorry, Mr. Dillon.
So what other kinds of triangles are there? Name them for me, guys. Peggy!
Taking copious notes as usual, right?
Just some notes. So what other kinds of triangles are there, Peg?
Scaly?
Guys,
please may I be excused?
Yes, of course you may.
Okay, sweetie.
Yeah. I'm too scared to come and get my stocking.
There's something sticky like glue in my brush.
Wait, one sec.
Yeah.
Gum. It's okay, Cindy, I'll help
you. Ow, that hurts!
Sorry.
It's okay, thanks for trying. Damn it!
Thank you.
That is not civilized behavior. So, you like to bite? You can't understand a word I'm saying. I get that. But I'll bet that you can guess I'm more than just a little bit upset with you right now. So I need to make sure you understand just who is in charge here. I've got kids to raise around here, lady. Disobedience is not something I want them to witness. They're very good kids. So I would very much like to introduce them to you. Can't do that. Okay. Plus, I need to feel better about losing my finger. I feel better about losing my finger now. One shy.
I heard you. What were you shooting at?
You'll see. What is that new tune? Where is it from?
Korea? I like it.
You'll spoil your dinner.
No, I can't.
You say that now.
I said what you do. Okay, everybody. Who wants to go down to the cellar with me?
What do you have in there, a mountain lion?
This is a hell of a lot better than a mountain lion, son.
Dad? What is this?
God only knows where she's been living, Peg. In the woods, in caves. We're gonna help her.
You need a big band-aid.
That's right. That's the first thing we're gonna fix. She's been wounded. We'll get right to it. Okay. We are all going to have to share in the responsibility of taking care of her. Ground rules. No touching. I learned the hard way that our friend here likes to bite.
She bit you.
She took an inch off my finger. Swallowed it.
Jesus. What are we going to do with her?
Trainer, Brian. Civilize her. Free her from herself, from her baser instincts. This woman thinks that she is an animal. And God only knows how she got that way, but we cannot have people running around the woods thinking they're animals. It isn't right. It's not safe. Belle? Could you, run up and put together a bowl of cereal or oatmeal or something simple? She's got to be hungry. The only thing she's had to eat since I captured her is...
finger.
Peg, go up and get the, first aid kit. I want to see to her wounds. Okay? Okay, let's go, girls. Come on. Better than a mountain woman, son.
We really get to keep her.
We do. Now, I cannot stress this enough. For the moment, everyone, keep your distance. What is that? Is that oatmeal?
Yes.
Good. Good. It's nice and nutritious. Just go ahead and set it down. Okay? So, Belle, you're going to set it down. But not too close. Good. And now, Brian, I want you to bring the rake. Okay, push it toward her. Be careful not to spill it. Come on. There you go. Great. Great. Everybody. It's teamwork. Okay, everybody did their part. See what I mean about keeping your distance? This next time we need to use Rubbermaid. She gets hungry enough, she'll eat. Okay, look. This is our project. And it's a secret. I shouldn't have to remind you to keep your mouth zipped, but I'm doing it anyway. We're all going to have to share in chores with this one. It's the same as taking care of the dogs. Someone's going to have to clean up after her and so on. Your mother and I will take care of anything overly complicated. Right, hon?
Yes.
Yeah. Okay, then. Well, dinner time. She may not be hungry, but I am. Okay, we'll work out the details later, okay? Let's go eat. Is everybody okay with that? Everybody okay? Yeah? Okay, let's go. Salt. How are things at school, kiddo?
Hi, Dad.
You're a good girl, Peg. I know it's hard sometimes being your age, but you've got to remember to look at things on the bright side. You're going to get your license soon, right? Your grades are good, aren't they?
Yeah.
And you're gonna go to college. Think about that.
Okay, Dad.
I love you, kiddo.
Love you too, Dad. That woman, do you really think we should be doing this?
Go to bed, babe. Toby, how are you?
Good morning, Mr. Cleek.
Morning, Dorothy. So, how did it go with Mrs. Oldenburg? She's satisfied with the papers?
Signed them right away. You have lunch with Dina at noon, court at 2, then a 3:30 with the oil company reps.
Okay, are the Ludlow files ready?
I just have to print out this last one.
Okay, fine. Well, look, when you're done with that, just bring them on in here, along with another cup of mud, and we'll get into it, okay? Thank you, Dorothy.
Stretching, then 8 laps, lady.
Something going on with her.
This last month or so, she's really changed.
They do at that age.
Yeah, but you know how they're all dressing these days. Short skirts and the skimpy blouses.
I hadn't noticed.
Point is, that's how she used to be too, you know? She's a very pretty girl. She ought to be...
wanting it?
Yeah, damn it. Wanting it.
Did you want it?
I made you pop your fucking zipper, Mr. Wolf.
Business, really, but in this economy, are you sure you're not overextending?
Have you ever known me to let things get out of hand? Still right there. No. That is a wonderful perfume. It's new, isn't it?
You like it?
I do. Very nice. It's very nice.
Yeah. Oh, no.
Oh.
What did you do?
got too close to a sweet smelling lady and she just...
At the table. What kind of cookie do you want?
I want a little man.
This one?
No.
This one?
No. Yes.
Papa's helping her, you heard him. I wanted to see if she was okay.
Is that what you want me to tell your father?
My little man. Hey, put the head first.
Not me. Watch out. Thanks, sis.
Well, the hell, Dina, I hated to have to write a check. It cost me a good deal. But if somebody had to. I could be of service. Sure. Sure. I don't think nothing of it. No. Oh, Bella and I'd be happy to help you with one of those bottles. No, but we can't tonight. We have a family. Another time, right? All right, good girl. Okay, I'll be talking to you, Dina. Okay, all right.
Dad. Did you know?
Thank you.
to you for a sec?
I don't want to be late for the next period.
All right, you all know.
Have a seat for a sec.
You all right?
Yeah, what?
Nausea? Baggy clothes? Miss Hindle tells me you've been sitting at a gym for weeks now. Hey, I'm not stupid, Peggy.
You're just minding your own business.
You are my business.
Where have you been?
Playing with the dogs. A little.
You?
Yeah. I do that sometimes. Huh.
So, are we ready, Belle?
Ready.
Okay, then. Grab the buckets. How are we doing today? I hate to do this to you. But with you, I'm not taking any more chances.
Scrub her down, Pop? I've never seen or smelled anything that nasty before.
Well, your mother and I are gonna scrub her down, but first you're gonna clean up her mess.
Me?
Grab the scoop shovel. Get a rag. I guess we're gonna have to keep doing this until we can get her, you know.
Body trained?
Exactly. Get.
But I can help.
Shut the door.
Maybe we should let that cool off a bit before.
Belle, we both know the only way to get something clean is with good hot water. Otherwise, we're just shuffling germs around. We use cold or, hell, even lukewarm. Good. See? Good. Look. There.
another bucket.
Get the bucket.
Don't look at me like you're jealous.
This has to be done. Could you bring another bucket, please?
Fix that. Oh, that's a good start. Thanks. Okay, I'm gonna need you to get Brian. Tell him to go to the woodshed. And I want him to get, a log. Tell him to cut it at 6 feet. We can't clean her down here. We're gonna have to take her outside. We're gonna need Peg, too. Thanks, Bill. You got it? Your mom and Peg.
Can I help?
No, you've done enough already.
Dad wants you. He wants Peg too.
Well, go get her.
Honey, Peg! Dad wants you!
Brian, go up and get her. Do not scream in my house.
Sorry.
and go up to your room and stay in there while we're working. Do you understand?
Go get the towels and get that first aid kit. Okay, let's go. Soaked in peroxide, please.
Here, so you don't have to. And you
it's great. Why don't you throw it on her? It's okay, she's not going to do it, huh? This is just all new to her, that's all. She's a little scared.
She has a lot of scars. Do you imagine she's
been doing.
Maybe someday she can tell us.
I think she likes it.
She's never had a dress on before. No. You probably did like the first time you had a dress on. It's like one of those polygamous wives, doesn't she?
My mind, babe. Your kids still giving you a heartache? No, they're fine. What's with the paper? It's a phone number and an address. Peggy Cleek's parents. Pretty sure she's pregnant. You're not thinking of telling them, are you? Shouldn't I? Could make things worse. It's gonna be very obvious very soon. It's your call. I gotta go lock up. I'll be back in a sec.
Hell, it never fails at dinner time.
Wow.
Peg? Mm-hmm. See your remains, please. On the phone all day. How do I make that noise? How do you make that noise?
A message.
How do I make that noise?
Hello. This is Genevieve Raton.
Huh?
Now, this message is from Mr. or Mrs. Cleek.
Your daughter Peggy is a student in my geometry class.
Message erased. You have no new messages.
It doesn't matter how it looks on his head.
Come on, turn that down. Peggy, what are you doing? It's time for school. Come on, I'm driving her today.
It's so good, Mom. Are you staying home today? Peggy, there is nothing wrong with you.
Had a hell of a day today, huh?
Yep.
What are you going to do with all that free time? Don't do anything I wouldn't do.
Okay, Dad. If I get up, I'm gonna be sick.
Fine. I don't want Brian to run after school anyway.
Doesn't like cookies.
Yeah.
What the hell are you doing, Brian? You're in trouble now. Get out of here. You're sick. I'm so sorry. About all of this. Darling, go to your room.
Why? I didn't do anything.
This isn't about you. This is about your brother. Go to your room. Good girl. Do you know what your son did? Do you want to know?
Not sure I do.
He didn't think anyone was home today, so he went down there with her, had her dress off, had her naked. He was touching her. And touching himself. If Peg hadn't caught him at it, there's no telling what would have gone on down there.
This is true, son.
Peg caught him. Didn't you hear me? Why the hell are you asking him, is it true?
Calm down, Belle.
He had one hand on her and the other down his goddamn jeans, Chris.
I'm telling you to take it easy. You better look at me when I'm talking to you. Is this true? Okay, so no one was hurt.
No. What?
No one was hurt. He's a boy. He's an adolescent. Adolescents have urges. Boys will be boys. You know, I mean, she's cleaned up. I have to say, she's not half bad to look at, you know what I mean?
I can't fucking do this anymore! You can't do this to us, Chris. Have you lost your mind? You can't just stand there and smile when your own son thinks it's okay to look
at. To what?
You are an officer of the court. She is a human being. Do you know what would happen to all of us if you got caught? Just what's going on with the goddamn dogs out there is enough to put you in prison.
Anna,
that Falmia banner, that is your shame. And at Falmia, you remember that? Do you?
I never condoned what you did. Never. You can't just keep putting one thing on top of the other and expect to get away with it forever. I've had it.
Okay. So what are you gonna do? I mean, what is your plan? What? I just would like to know. What the fuck you think you're gonna do about it?
I'm leaving. I'm leaving you, Chris. Mm-hmm. And I'm taking the girls with me. You can have your little rapist son to yourself. You're already teaching him every goddamn thing he needs to know, aren't you? You can damn well burn together, the two of you. But you are not hurting my girls anymore. It's over. Right now! You can't do this to us, Chris. I can't do this. I can't. I can't.
She'll be fine. She's okay. Get a cold cloth for your mother, Peg. Peg, let's go. Why don't you answer the door? See who it is.
Mr. Tom?
Peggy. Hi. You gonna invite me in? This really isn't the time.
Sure it is, Peggy. Hey, I'm not here to hurt you. I want to help.
You can't help.
How do you know that?
I just do.
I know doctors, counselors, all kinds of people.
I said this isn't the time, Mr. Tone.
Peg, where are your manners? Hi, come on in.
Thank you.
Miss...
Matone.
Matone. I remember. Yeah. Geometry.
Yes.
Geometry. That's right. I met you at parents' night.
Yes.
Please have a seat. Can I get you anything? Are you thirsty? Would you like some soda pop or coffee? Nothing?
I'm fine, thank you.
Okay.
May I speak with you?
wife privately, Mr. Cleek?
Please call me Chris, Miss Raton.
Chris.
And you are...
Genevieve.
Genevieve. Genevieve. It's a beautiful name. She's really not feeling very well. She's having herself a little power nap. So this is about Peg, I gather.
Yes.
Then I suppose she should hear it. My son as well. We have no secrets in this family, Miss Raton. Brian! Come here, son.
Observe some distressing behavior as of late, Mr. Cleek.
Chris?
Chris. Peggy isn't looking well. She's had to rush out to use the ladies' restroom several times during class. Her studies are off, and she's taken to wearing clothes that are much too big for her.
Well, she does like to wear my sweats.
Does Peggy have a boyfriend? Do you know Mr. Cleek?
No. And I would know if she did. Why?
I believe that Peggy is pregnant, Mr. Cleek.
Pregnant?
I am not.
What makes you think that Peggy is pregnant, Mr. Tom?
Well, she's showing, Mr. Cleek, and not very much right now, but that won't last much longer.
Do any of your colleagues concur with this opinion, Ms. Raton?
I wouldn't know. I haven't discussed it with them. I thought it best to come directly to you and your wife.
It was good of you to do so. I thought teachers were supposed to listen, but you're not very good at listening, are you, Miss Raton? Because I told you Peggy does not have a boyfriend. And that if she did, I would know about it. Did I not say that?
Yes. But...
So you're accusing Brian? He's just a boy.
Absolutely not.
So you're accusing me?
No. No, I...
No, you're accusing me?
Dad!
You come to my house, and you accuse me of something like that.
I said nothing of the sort, Mr. Cleek.
I know you didn't say anything of the sort. It's what you haven't said. Do you think I'm stupid? Do you think I'm stupid?
No.
Ms. Raton?
Yes.
You don't really... think that I would want to miss out on heaven, do you? Hey, Brian? You should get the rope.
Hey, Ah! Thank you.
Yeah.